वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक स्प्रेडिंग कोएफिशिएंट। स्प्रेडिंग कोएफिशिएंट इज नथिंग बट एबिलिटी ऑफ वन लिक्विड टू स्प्रेड ओवर द सरफेस ऑफ अनादर लिक्विड, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द स्प्रेडिंग कोएफिशिएंट। नाउ वील टेक वन एग्जाम्पल एंड डिस्कस दिस स्प्रेडिंग कोएफिशिएंट। When a liquid is placed on the surface of other liquid, it will spread as a film. If adhesion force is greater than cohesive force, okay, means adhesive force means force between the dislike molecules, force between the two different molecules, and cohesive force means force of attraction between like molecules. When a substance such as oleic acid is placed on a surface of water, it will spread as a film if the force of adhesion between the oleic acid molecule and the water molecule is greater than the cohesive force between oleic acid molecule themselves. Okay, here we have taken example of oleic acid and water, and we are trying to spread this oleic acid on the surface of water. Now when force of attraction between oleic acid molecule and water molecule is greater, then and then only spreading of the liquid on the surface of another liquid is there. Otherwise, there is no spreading of that oleic acid on the surface of water. When these adhesive forces are greater than the cohesive forces between the molecules themselves. Molecules themselves means force of attraction between water molecules, and secondly, force of attraction between oleic acid molecules. These forces are nothing but the cohesive forces, and that cohesive forces should be less as compared to the adhesive force, then there is a spreading. The work of adhesion, which is the energy required to break the attraction between like molecules, is obtained okay, this is your water surface and this is your second liquid surface, which is spread on the surface of your water. So this part will show you surface, okay. It is a surface of oleic acid molecule, and above to this oleic acid air is present. Now this line is showing interface, because this line is lies in between these two liquid, one is oleic acid and second is water, so it is interface. Now this figure represents the work of adhesion involved in separating a substrate and overlaying liquid. Means how much work is required to separate that molecule from each other, because adhesive forces are present at the interface of these two liquid, and work done is required to separate that molecule from each other, that is your work of adhesion. A hypothetical cylinder with cross sectional area 1 cm square of sublayer liquid S overlay with similar section of spreading liquid L. Okay, L represent spreading liquid while S represent sublayer liquid. So surface or interfacial work is equal to surface tension multiplied by area increment. The work required to separate these two sections of liquid, as shown in the figure, each with cross-sectional area of 1 cm square, is therefore numerically related to the surface and interfacial tension involved by area increment. So work done required to separate the molecule is nothing but surface tension into unit area change. Means what is the what exactly the value of cross-sectional area of that liquid, and here it is 1 cm square, so work done is equal to surface tension. The work done is equal to newly created surface tension, that is gamma L and gamma S, minus interfacial tension gamma LS, that has been destroyed in the process. The work of adhesion, thus we can write that gamma L plus gamma S minus gamma LS. Okay, gamma L means surface tension of that spreading liquid, that is surface tension of your oleic acid, plus surface tension of sublayer. Now sublayer is nothing but your water, so you have to take a surface tension of water. Then minus surface tension at the interface of your oleic acid and water, that is nothing but gamma LS. Now by calculating this, you will get value of work of adhesion. Gamma L is nothing but surface tension of spreading liquid, and gamma S surface tension of sublayer. Okay, we have taken example of oleic acid and water, so gamma L represents surface tension of your oleic acid, and gamma S represents surface tension of water, and gamma LS is a interfacial tension at the interface of your oleic acid and water. Okay, now we'll discuss second point, that is work of cohesion. Okay, we have discussed about how much energy is required to separate out the molecules which are present at the interface by applying the force, and that force is nothing but work done. Now we'll discuss work of cohesion. It is involved in separating like molecules in the liquid. Work of cohesion required to separate the molecules of spreading liquid so that it can flow over sublayer is obtained by considering above figure. Suppose this is your cylinder of a liquid, and we want to calculate work of cohesion, means work is required to separate the like molecules. Okay, now you have to consider this is a cylinder of your water, and you want to cut it into the two sublayers or into the two separate parts. Now separation of this cylinder required some force. That force is nothing but work of cohesion. No interfacial tension exists between the like molecule of liquid when hypothetically 1 cm square cylinder in the figure is divided, two new surfaces are created as shown in figure, each with surface tension gamma L. okay, previously you have a system with you, and force of cohesion is present in this. Now you want to cut it into the two separate part, okay, for separation of this single cylinder into two cylinder required some work done. That work done is nothing but work of cohesion, okay. And after cutting the cylinder into the two separate part, there is a formation of two surfaces. This one is first surface and this one is second surface, and this surface is having a surface tension, that is gamma L. Therefore, work of cohesion is WC is equal to 2 into gamma L, because two surfaces are formed and surface tension of these two surfaces is nothing but your work of cohesion. Spreading occurs if work of adhesion, that is measure of force of attraction between the oil and water, is greater than work of cohesion, then only there is a spreading. So the term work WA minus WC, that is work of adhesion minus work of cohesion, is known as spreading coefficient, and it is denoted by capital S. If it is positive, then the oil will spread over the water surface. If value of this S is positive, then oil easily spread on the surface of your water. Spreading coefficient S is equal to work of adhesion minus work of cohesion. But we have a value of work of adhesion with us, that is nothing but gamma L plus gamma S minus gamma LS. So just you have to put this value of work of adhesion in this equation, and WC, that is work of cohesion, is equal to 2 gamma L. So I just replaced these values in this equation. So value of your work of adhesion, gamma L plus gamma S minus gamma LS, and value of work of cohesion, 2 gamma L. Now by calculating this equation, we'll get value S is equal to gamma S minus gamma L minus gamma LS. Okay, this is final equation for spreading coefficient. When free energy of spreading liquid and the interfacial tension with sublayer is less than that of sublayer, the spreading becomes spontaneous at attempt to reduce free energy of sublayer. There may be a saturation of liquid with the other, and there may be change in the surface tension of sublayer. Because of saturation, there might be changes into the spreading coefficient. In that case, a spreading coefficient may become negative after saturation, and the spreading liquid coalesces and form a lens on the surface of the sublayer. In the case of duplex film, if S become negative after saturation, it form a monolayer and excess liquid remain as a lens on this surface. Fatty acid and alcohol have a high spreading coefficient. As nonpolar chain length increases in an acid and alcohol, then spreading coefficient or spreading ability of this nonpolar liquid decreases. Then propionic acid and ethyl alcohol having high spreading coefficient, while light petroleum do not spread on water surface. because value of gamma s, that is sub layer, is less. Significance of spreading coefficient, absorption of medicament from cream, lotions, then stabilization of emulsion and in coating of tablet. Now we'll discuss factors affecting on spreading coefficient. There are two factors which are affecting on this spreading coefficient, that is cohesive force and molecular structure. Greater the polarity of molecule, more positive value of spreading coefficient. For example, ethyl alcohol and propionic acid. Then non-polar substances as a liquid petroleum have a negative value of spreading coefficient, so it fails to spread on a water surface. For organic acid as oleic acid, the longer the carbon chain decreases in polar characteristic and also decreases the spreading coefficient. Some oil can separate over water surface because they contain polar group as COOH and OH. So these type of the liquid are having a positive spreading coefficient value, so they are able to spread over the sublayer. Second factor, that is cohesive forces. Benzene spread on a surface of water not because it is polar, but because of cohesive forces between its molecule are much weaker than adhesive force for water. So it unable to spread on the surface of your water. Now we'll discuss applications of this spreading coefficient in pharmacy. Okay, there are three basic applications of the spreading coefficient. First application, it helpful to form a film coat on tablet surface. This is required when you want to coat your tablet, and during this coating there should be the proper film formation on the surface of your tablet, otherwise there will be the formation of coating defect. Okay, so you have to adjust your spreading liquid in such a way that it form a film on the surface of your tablet. Second application, the requirement of lotion with mineral oil is spread on a skin by addition of surfactant. So spreading coefficient we have to adjust by using this surfactant in a such a way that when you apply this lotion on the surface of your body, it should be easily spread. Then stabilization of emulsion. After addition of surfactant, we have to adjust this spreading coefficient in a such a way that it stabilizes emulsion. Okay, this is all about spreading coefficient. Thank you.